周三刚刚结束的美中人权对话，美国众议院外交委员会就中国目前不断恶化的人权状况举办了一场听证会。曾在中国饱受迫害的法轮功学员李海在听证会中促请美国政府公开谴责中共活摘器官的暴行。
这场听证会由众议院外委会主席罗斯莱廷恩主持，多位中国受迫害团体代表出席。
One must wonder when reading the latest State Department Human Rights Report on China, what value is there in the so-called Human Rights Dialogue that recently concluded?
罗斯莱廷恩议员指出，美国政府将贸易与人权问题分离开的做法，客观上纵容了中共对人权的迫害。
In 1999, just a year before PNTR was passed,The Chinese regime began its relentless campaign of torture and suppression against the spiritual movement known as Falun Gong. The infamous 610 office, a secret unit as brutal as the KGB, was established at that time to hunt down, persecute, torture, and even kill Falun Gong practitioners.
法轮功学员李海曾是中共外交部调法司官员。自从1999年江泽民发起对法轮功的镇压后，他因不肯放弃信仰，四次被抓捕关押，最长的一次7年。他在证词中谈到，中共通过所谓洗脑转化迫害法轮功学员，以及中共摘取法轮功学员器官的暴行。
As U.S. Department of State reports, the horrific organ harvesting of Falun Gong practitioners taking place in China now, and we have also noticed that Chinese public, are speaking up to defend Falun Gong's rights by signing petitions.Are using fingerprints to show their support and solidarity with Falun Gong.
现场，李海展示出一份请愿信，信中700位河北正定县民众要求当局立即无罪释放法轮功学员李兰奎。
就是希望美国政府啊，还有所有这个正义人士啊，都能对中国政府对法轮功学员的迫害进行公开的谴责，尤其是这种活摘法轮功学员器官的这种惨无人道的行为吧。必须马上停止，不能再继续了。
国会议员史密斯也表示，将围绕法轮功和活摘器官议题举办系列听证会。这是新唐人记者王凯迪，美国首都华盛顿报道。